243 summers ago, 56 men signed our nation's Declaration of Independence. Only one of those was Catholic, Charles Carroll. Correspondent Jason Calvi sat down with a descendant to learn more about our founding father.
Do Catholics know enough about your ancestor?
Undoubtedly, they do not.
Charles Carroll Carter bears the name of a founding father, his distant cousin, an honor he passed down to his son, Charles Jr.
This was the promised land for people that wanted to start new, and no one knew that better than the Carrolls, because in 1550, the British came in and took all of the Carrolls' property away from them in Ireland.
The Carroll family settled in Maryland, the Catholic colony, but they ran into old world troubles with the British.
No public Catholic education. As a result, all three go to France and study.
That would begin to change July 4th, 1776.
But some people say that the thing that drove Charles Carroll mostly to sign was because when he signed, he wanted to be known as the person who was signing for his faith, because his faith was so important to him. Why else do you have a chapel in your house if it doesn't mean something to you?
Charles Carroll was the only Catholic to sign the Declaration of Independence.
Well, I think it means that that document is intended to be all inclusive.
Charles is part of a big Catholic family. His cousin John Carroll became the first bishop in America. Here at the Capitol, this Catholic founder is honored on land the Carrolls deeded to the federal city.
When it came time for Washington to form the federal city, he walked around and he said, where are we going to put this monument to democracy? And L'Enfant, again, a Frenchman, said, here is a pedestal waiting for a monument on Capitol Hill.
And so we see the Carroll property, we see the National Mall, we see the U.S. Capitol, Supreme Court, Union Station, Navy Yard. All of these areas were deeded, given to the district by the Carroll family?
Well, the land was. Of course, years later, the buildings come.
Charles Carroll was the last of the Declaration signatories to die, November 1832.
Charles Carroll made it to 95?
He did.
In one of his last interviews, he was asked, you know, all of your friends are gone. You're the last of the great Americans. How do you keep yourself company? And he pointed to his stand next to his easy chair. And on that, he had both the New Testament and the collected works of Cicero. And he said, well, you know, my best friends are Jesus and Cicero, and I talk to them all the time and they listen.
95 years of promoting life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. In Washington, Jason Calvi, EWTN News Nightly.
Thanks, Jason. So many interesting aspects of American history.